So coming to the pulpotomy, right? Whenever there is a larger pulpal exposure, either a cavus exposure or due to the trauma, and even the patient has reported late and the inflammation is not seems to be reversible in the coronal portion. However, the radicular portion of the pulp seems to be healthy. In those situations, this pulpotomy procedure is carried out. This is more invasive compared to the pulp therapies what we have discussed. Okay, the pulpotomy by definition, that is given by Finn, is a complete removal of coronal portion of the dental pulp, followed by placement of a suitable medicament that will promote healing and preserve the vitality and function of the remaining radicular pulp. So another definition given by American Academy of Pediatric Dentistry, that is pulpotomy, is defined as amputation of affected infected coronal portion of the dental pulp, preserving the vitality and function of the remaining part of the radicular pulp. The rationale being to remove the coronal pulp, which has been clinically diagnosed as irreversibly inflamed, leaving behind a possibly healthy or reversibly inflamed radicular pulp. So, what are the indications? Vital tooth with healthy periodontium. Pain, if present, is neither spontaneous nor persistent. These are the things which will tell us about the reversibility of the condition. If there is a spontaneous or a persistent pain, then it is goes to a irreversibility of the condition. The tooth that possesses at least 2/3 of the root length. The hemorrhage from the amputated site is pale and easy to control. Permanent with pulpal exposures, either due to trauma or dental caries, when the root formation is incomplete. That is related to the immature permanent teeth. The contraindications being excessive bleeding from the amputated site, purulent or a serious exudate, history of spontaneous and nocturnal pain, any signs of periapical pathologies, tenderness to percussion, abnormal mobility, abscess or fistula, or presence of any interradicular radiolucency or a tooth close to its natural exfoliation. So, how do we classify this pulpotomy medicament? That is depending on their function or the body, how it responds to that material. That is been classified as devitalization, preservation, and regeneration. So, devitalization materials being a formocresol, yes, it has got its own drawbacks and advantages, and electrosurgery, laser. The preservation pulpotomy includes done by the zinc oxide regional, glutaraldehyde, most commonly by the ferric sulfate. And the regenerative procedures can be done with calcium hydroxide. And there are many, like enriched collagen, hard-setting calcium hydroxide, freeze-dried bone, demineralized dentin. The newer materials like MTA, bioglass, even the biodentin can be used as a pulpotomy medicaments. The newer materials, again, the biologic materials like bone morphogenetic proteins and osteogenic proteins can also be used as a pulpotomy medicaments for primary teeth as well as the permanent tooth. So, usually, this is the thing which has been routinely discussed in the textbooks, and nowadays, it is not being practiced as a much, but this is the one which has been first we are going to talk with it. The procedure, we will see whether how the other pulpotomy procedures are also being done. Only the difference would be the material or the medicament what we are using is going to change, and the procedure remains to be the same. So, formocresol, as was introduced by Buckley long back in 1904, since then, a lot of modifications have been tried and advocated, like Sweet introduced the multi-visit pulpotomy procedure in 1930. Later, Doyle advocated as two setting procedures, that is complete devitalization of the pulp. And Spedding has given a 5-minute protocol, that is a partial devitalization. Venham has given a proposed 15 seconds procedure. However, the current concept, what we usually recommend is a 4 minutes of application of this formocresol in a pulpotomy procedure. So, materials used for, and there are certain materials which are used for two-visit pulpotomy. And they have been used as desensitizing pulp therapy, also it is called as. These include VC Stro paste, Aslix paraformaldehyde paste, paraform devitalizing paste. Okay, the composition has been given as that. The main constituent being the paraformaldehyde, right, with other ingredients into it. And these are used for two-visit pulpotomy that we are going to discuss further. Okay. Then we'll continue with the pulpotomy in a primary tooth with the Buckley's Formocresol. That is the 20%, that is the 1/5 of concentration which is usually being used. First is to anesthetize the tooth, and application of rubber dam is must. Then completely remove the caries, open the pulp chamber, remove the coronal pulp tissue, irrigate the pulp chamber, preferably with sodium hypochlorite. Control the bleeding with a moist cotton pellet, place Formocresol damped cotton pellet into the pulp chamber, remove the cotton pellet, check for the fixed pulp, and followed by the restoration. Just we will see the clinical pictures about it. After anesthesia, proper anesthesia of the tooth, it has been isolated with the use of rubber dam. Then completely remove the caries and determine the site of exposure, which is followed by the opening of the pulp chamber completely by removing the roof with 330 high speed burr, and remove the pulp from the chamber with a large spoon excavator or a large round burr in a slow speed. Once it has been done, a cotton pellet which is damped with Formocresol, that is the excess of the Formocresol has been squeezed out. Only Formocresol is damped, it is not wet. It is damped with Formocresol, has to be placed in the pulp chamber for 4 minutes. After that, take out and see that the pulp has been fixed, that is the dark brown color orifices you could able to see, that it will show you the fixation of the pulp. Later, the pulp is filled with the cement, that is reinforcing oxidation on, or a glass enamel cement. Then the permanent restoration of the tooth is done with a stainless steel crown. This is the best coronal seal what we can have as for the primary tooth, even in permanent teeth. This will show you the preoperative radiograph and a post-operative radiograph after the pulpotomy and the stainless steel crown. Particularly when we were keeping that, when we talk about the other pulpotomies or the other pulpotomy medicaments, only the medicament is going to change. That is after amputation of the coronal pulp, irrigation with the sodium hypochlorite, particularly it can be used at 1% or at 2.5% or in a 5.2% also, but the better results with the diluted hypochlorite has already been seen with this thing. So after irrigation with sodium hypochlorite and a normal saline, then when the bleeding has been stopped, one of the advantages of the using a sodium hypochlorite irrigant is it prevents the formation of extravascular plaque, which is danger, which is usually considered to be one of the responsible factors for the internal resorption and the harboring of the microorganisms. Even the hypochlorite has got a good antimicrobial effect and as well as prevents the extravascular blood clot which is going to be found or a coagulation which is to be seen over there, that needs to be prevented. So after this, then you can put other materials like an MTA, mixed MTA or a biodentine or bioglass, which can be placed into the chin and followed by a restoration and permanent restoration by the stainless steel crown. This is the only modification what you can see apart from the Formocresol pulpotomy. Then this is a graphical diagrammatic representation of the same what we have discussed till now. There is a zinc oxide regional followed by a base and a permanent restoration and then a stainless steel crown restoration. Then when we have discussed about the Formocresol pulpotomy, we are going to see several zones which have been formed after a week's time. That is a broad eosinophilic zone of fixation in the coronal third of the canals. a pale staining zone of atrophy with poor cellular infiltration in the middle zone and a broad zone of inflammation which is extending apically into the normal pulp tissue. Then pulpotomy in the permanent teeth. Whenever there is a traumatic injury to the young permanent teeth with an open apices or a carious exposure, right? Calcium hydroxide is indicated to promote healing and root completion. Okay. This is particularly we will see in detail when we talk about the apexogenesis procedure. Right. Whenever there is a traumatic injury and resulted in exposure of the pulp of the permanent immature tooth and permanent tooth, then pulpal tissue, which is judged to be little more inflamed, to be removed from 1 to 3 millimeters from the exposure site, it is irrigated properly and bleeding is controlled. After that, calcium hydroxide or an MTA, which has to be placed as a medicament over that, and it is been restored. Right, like that, if this is considered to be the sex pulpotomy or the partial pulpotomy, this is also called as a calcium hydroxide pulpotomy for the young permanent tooth or a partial pulpotomy. This was proposed by the Cveck in 1978, indicated in young permanent teeth where the pulp is exposed by mechanical or the bacterial means and the remaining radicular pulp is judged to be vital by the clinical and radiographic criteria, whereas the root closure is not complete, that is, it is an young permanent tooth. The rationale being to preserve the vitality of the remaining pulp and allow for the normal root closure to happen. Okay, here we are not going to ampute the whole coronal pulp, we are going to ampute 1 to 3 millimeters below the exposure site, and it is when the bleeding is controllable, it is when it is irrigated and bleeding can be controlled, and the remaining pulp is judged to be the unaffected or where the bleeding you are going to control it properly, then you can go ahead with the placement of a medicament. If you see that the pulp chamber is again oozing out with the red blood, even in this situation or in the pulpotomy for the primary teeth, that is considered to be not a candidate for this pulpotomy procedure. More invasive procedure is required in those particular things. Okay. So that is the thing we usually take it to an on-table decision whether the tooth is going for a pulpotomy or a pulpectomy when we consider the primary teeth. But in an immature tooth, when there is a trauma and the patient has reported immediately, then we can go ahead with the partial pulpotomy or the Cvek pulpotomy. That is removal of 1 to 3 millimeter of the pulpal tissue beneath the exposure and irrigate it, control the bleeding, placement of a material that is usually the bioinductive material, and seal the, we have a proper coronal seal on top of it by our reinforced glass enamel cement or a composite resin.